Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 3.2, Problem 3. This is question number 3 from Section 3.2. It says maximize z equals 7x plus 3y, subject to 3x plus y is less than or equal to 12, x plus y is greater than or equal to 2, x is greater than or equal to 0, y is greater than or equal to 0. So to start a problem like this, what you have to do, it's a four-step process. Step one is graph the feasible region. So your feasible region are made up of the constraints, the ones with the inequality symbols. The object function, the problem with the equation, is not part of the graph. We use that later. So z equals 7x plus 3y doesn't become part of the graph. 3x plus y is less than or equal to 12 will be the graph, part of the graph of the feasible region. So to put that on the graph, what I do is I make a little chart next to it with an x column and a y column. And to fill it in, I pretend that I have 3x plus y equals 12. Ignore the less than or equal to at this point. And I want to find two points that make that true if I'm pretending that it's an equation, if I have 3x plus y equals 12. You can find all kinds of points, but it's very easy to deal with zeros. So if I try a 0 for x first, the 3x becomes 3 times 0 and it goes away. And I have y equals 12. So if y is 12, the equation will be true. I'd have 12 equals 12 when x is 0. Now the other point will come from letting y equal 0. And again, I'm pretending that I have an equation, not an inequality. So if y is 0, my equation becomes 3x equals 12. Well, x would have to be 4. 3 times 4 would make 12 equals 12. So I have those two points, 0, 12, and 4, 0. And then for the other one with the 2, I'll make the same little xy chart, x column or y column. Again, pretend it's x plus y equals 2. This one's pretty easy. If I let x equal 0, the equation becomes y equals 2. And then if I let y equal 0, I get the equation x equals 2. Now I want to put those in the graph and shade them correctly. So the first linear inequality with a 12 at the end, I want to plot the point 0, 12. So that's over 0, up 12, which is up there. The other point is 4, 0, so over 4, up 0. I put that on the graph. And now I'm going to connect them with a straight line. And I have to decide if I shade above that line or below it, or to the left or to the right. So to decide which side of the line you want to shade, you're going to choose a test point that's not on the line. Use 0, 0 if you can. 0, 0 is not on the line, so I can use it as a test point. If I put in 0 for x and 0 for y, the statement I get is 0 is less than or equal to 12. Well, that's true. 0 is smaller than 12. So my test point was from the underneath side. It gave me a result that's true. So that underneath side must be in the shaded region. I'm going to shade under. The next linear inequality is the one with the 2. So we had found two points for that. One of them is 0, 2. So 0, 2 over 0, up 2 would be that point on my graph. And then the other point, 2, 0, would be over 2, up 0. I'll circle that in. I'm going to connect those two points with a straight line. And again, I need to decide, do I shade above that line or below it? Same process. Choose a test point that's not on the line. Use 0, 0 if you can. So 0, 0 is not on the line. I can certainly use it. Put in 0 for x, 0 for y, and I get the statement 0 is greater than 2. That's not true. 0 is not greater than 2. So my test point was on the underneath side. It gave me a result that was false. Therefore, the underneath side is blank. That means the up above side, the op side, is shaded. Now, the next linear inequality or constraint is x is greater than or equal to 0. It means all the points in our feasible region have to have x coordinates that are positive. It's going to keep us to the right of the y-axis. And the last constraint is y is greater than or equal to 0. It's going to keep us above the x-axis. All the points in my feasible region have to have y coordinates that are positive, is what that amounts to. So now my feasible region is everything in this. It's kind of looks like a triangle with the bottom corner sliced off a little bit. So solving this problem is a four-part process. Part one is graph the feasible region. So we have graphed the feasible region. Step two is label the corner points. Now the corner points are easy enough to label. The top corner point is 0, 12. Now be careful in the order in which you list the 0 and the 12. This is 0, 12, not 12, 0. It makes a big difference. 12, 0 would be way over on the x-axis way off to the right, which is not the point we have. We want 0, 12, not 12, 0. There's a difference, so pay attention. This one is 0, 2. The next corner point coming around is 2, 0. And the last corner point is 4, 0, over 4, up 0. So now we have all the corner points listed. That's step two, label your corner points. Step three, set up that chart that has the object function in the middle and fill it in. So I'm going to have my three columns. The first column will be for the corner points. The middle column, which I leave wider, will be for the object function. So now I'm going to use that equation, z equals 7x plus 3y. That's the object function. And then the last column is output. So for the corner points, just list them all. Any order is fine as long as you don't miss any. So I will list 0, 12, 4, 0, 2, 0, and 0, 2. Those are all my corner points. And now for each one, I'm going to plug them into the equation that we call the object function, z equals 7x plus 3y, and calculate the output. The first corner point is 0, 12. So z equals 7 times x becomes 7 times 0. 3 times y is 3 times 12. 7 times 0 is 0. 3 times 12 is 36. So 0 plus 36 is 36. The next corner point is 4, 0. So my object function would be z equals 7x becomes 7 times 4. 3 times y becomes 3 times 0. So now 7 times 4 is 28, and 3 times 0 is 0. 28 plus 0 is 28. And the next corner point is 2, 0. So z equals 7 times x becomes 7 times 2. 3 times y becomes 3 times 0. 7 times 2 is 14. 3 times 0 is 0. 14 plus 0 is 14. And finally, one last corner point, 0, 2. X is 0, y is 2. So now when I put that in the object function, z equals 7 times x becomes 7 times 0. And 3 times y is 3 times 2. 7 times 0 is 0. 3 times 2 is 6. 0 plus 6 is 6. So step 3 of my four-part process is fill in the chart that we just filled in. And the final step, step four, is state your solution. Now we want to maximize in this problem, because some could say minimize. This is a maximize. Our choices for the output are 36, 28, 14, or 6. Well, the biggest output is 36. So when you state your solution, we will say maximum of 36. And you have to say where you got the 36 from. So underneath we'll put at the point. Now that maximum output of 36 occurred at the corner point 0, 12. At 0, 12. So the answer to problem number 3 is we have a maximum of 36 at the point 0, 12.